Well, good morning, boys and girls, and thanks for joining me for today's Bible Zone video. Today, we're going to get started with our action memory verse, followed by the Bible story time, and then we'll finish with the Bible Zone praise song. Are you ready to have some fun? Okay, here we go. So our action memory verse is from the book of Psalms, chapter 19, verse 1. And it says this, it says, "The heavens declare the glory of God." Now, when we say heavens, it's not heaven, like where God is. Heavens means like everything beyond the sky, like all of outer space and the stars, the moon, the sun, all of those amazing things that God has created. It says the heavens declare. That means it's almost like they are speaking, even though they're not really speaking. It's almost like they're telling us, like, look how amazing God is. So it says the heavens declare the glory of God, the greatness, the majesty of who God is. He's so powerful and amazing. So let's do it now with the actions. Are you ready? Okay, so we're going to say Psalms chapter 19, verse 1. The heavens declare the glory of God. Did you get that? Let's do it one more time. Psalms chapter 19, verse 1. The heavens declare the glory of God. Excellent. Last week's video was called Nehemiah Rebuilt the Walls. Let's see what happens in this week's video.
The walls around Jerusalem were finished, at last. With God's help, the people finished rebuilding the walls and the city gates in just 52 days. Ezra, a priest and scribe, had traveled from Babylon to Jerusalem with a group of God's people. God was with Ezra, and Ezra wanted to study God's law, obey it, and teach it to God's people. Ezra met with some of the people of Israel. He learned that some of the people and their leaders had disobeyed God, ignoring his word. Ezra tore his clothes, and he pulled out some of his hair. He sat down and was very upset. Ezra got on his knees and he prayed to God, confessing the people's sin. As he did this, God's people began to gather around him. They cried too and offered sacrifices, promising to be faithful to God. Several years later, the people in Jerusalem gathered together early in the morning at one of Jerusalem's gates. Men, women, and children, anyone who could understand, came to listen to the reading of God's word. As the sun was just coming up, Ezra brought out the book of the law of Moses that God had given to his people. God's words were written on a scroll. Ezra stood on a high wooden platform and began to read. Ezra read the law for hours, and all the people listened carefully. The people stood up. They had respect for God's word. Ezra praised God, and the people lifted up their hands. "Amen, amen," they said. The people in the crowd bowed down with their faces to the ground, and they worshiped God. Some of the leaders there, the Levites, explained the law to the people and helped them understand the words Ezra read. As the people heard the words of the law, they began to cry. The law was God's rules for living, and the people had disobeyed God. They realized they had sinned. Ezra, the Levites, and Nehemiah, the governor, said, "This day is holy to the Lord your God. Do not be sad or cry." Even though the people's sin made them sad, this was a happy day. Then Ezra said to them, "Go home and prepare a feast. Eat rich food and drink sweet drinks. Share what you have prepared with those who have nothing prepared." The people obeyed Ezra. They prepared a feast. They were glad because they understood the words of the law that were explained to them. God's word is powerful. When Ezra read God's word, the people loved God more and changed their ways. The Bible says that Jesus is the Word. Jesus is God who came to live with people on earth. Jesus has the power to change our hearts.
So, boys and girls, as we saw in that video, as Ezra began to read the law, the word of God, he really was upset, and the people became upset as well because they realized how terribly they had been disobeying and sinning against God. But Ezra was also comforted to know that God can forgive sin, and he is a God who does forgive sin. So that was a really, really good thing. But he realized that something needed to change. So one of the amazing things about God's word, the Bible, is that it shows us our sin. And sometimes we don't like to hear that. Or sometimes we might think, well, God is mean for pointing out that I've messed up and I've done wrong. But that's not true at all. Now, I want you to think about it like this. Imagine if you went to the doctor and you were really, really, really sick, but you didn't know it, you didn't understand it. If the doctor did some tests and realized that you were really sick and you needed to have some medicine to make sure you got better, he would have to tell you about your sickness. He would have to tell you so that he could then show you the treatment, the medicine that you need in order to get well. So when God points out our sin in his word, in the Bible, it's not because he's mean, it's because he's God and he knows what's best and he knows what's right and he made us. So when he sees us doing things that are bad for us and that are disobeying him, he's trying to tell us, look, don't do that because you might think it's okay or it's not a big deal, but it is a big deal and it's bad for you. So I want you to know about it so that then you can come to me for the forgiveness that I have to offer you. So that's what took place in this story. And Nehemiah trusted God, the people trusted God, that when they confessed their sin, God would be faithful. He would keep his promise to forgive their sin. So when Ezra read the law and saw how much the people had been sinning, he wanted to encourage the people that, look, we should confess this to God. We should repent, turn away from our sin. We should be sorry, but we need to go a step further than that. We can't just say we're sorry. We need to turn back towards God and commit ourselves to obey and follow his law, not just say sorry for breaking it. And that's exactly what took place. Boys and girls, since we're talking about the Bible, you might ask the question, does it matter if I don't read the whole Bible? Like, can I just skip some parts? There's some parts I don't like. Do I have to read it all? Well, that's a good question. And boys and girls, I'm gonna be honest with you. There's some parts of the Bible that I find kind of difficult to read. But the important thing to know is that all of the Bible is God's word, God's special message to us. And there's so many things that we can learn from the Bible about God and even about ourselves. So it's very important that we value it, that we understand how important all of it is. If there are parts that we find difficult to understand or we're not getting it, well, we should just continue to read it and to pray to God to help us to understand it. Another thing I want to encourage you is to pray to God about it and say, God, help me to understand this better. You can also come to church regularly so that you can hear God's word from the pastor, from your Bible Zone teachers, to help you understand what it's telling us. And sometimes even sharing with other Christian friends can help you to understand things, because there might be some things that I don't understand about the Bible that someone else does because God's helped them to understand. So we talk it through, we read God's word and go back to it, and God will show us what we need to know. But we do need to understand how important all of the Bible is. It's not just something that people wrote. God is the one who directed and guided people to write everything that's in the Bible. So it's true and it's important that we know it. So I'd like to close with this question. How can you make it a habit to read the Bible? All right, boys and girls, it's time for our Bible Zone praise song. The song we're going to do today is called Me Without You. And this song is reminding us that without God, we'd be lost and confused. We'd be packing our bags when we're supposed to stay. So let's remember that we need God's direction and we need to follow him. Let's think about that as we sing this song, Me Without You.
Your arms, right where I belong, your everlasting arms. rise when I need to stay. I be chasing every breeze that blows my way. I be building my kingdom just to watch it fade away. It's true, that's me without you. Ooh, 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 ooh. That's me without you.
Okay, boys and girls, before we close in our prayer, I want to remind you, if you have any questions at all, you can email me at the email address below, but make sure you get mom or dad's permission first. All right, let's pray to God. Dear God, I thank you that in the Bible, you show us what things are good and true, and you tell us the things that are sins, not because you're mean, but because you know what's best for us. So God, I pray that we would read your word, that we would confess our sin, but more than that, we would also turn away from our sin and turn towards you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen, amen. Boys and girls, thank you so much for watching today's video. And remember, when we sin, we should feel sorry that we've disobeyed God and want to turn from our sin because we love him. I'll see you next week.